tremendous dramatic increase in urban expansion. So urban growth, mostly in China, India, and other places, will consume agricultural land to an enormous extent. And recent calculations show that for the next 40 years, urban growth will consume land approximately 3 times the size of France. And this is not just random land. This is often the most prime agricultural land. And what we will see happen in the world with an increasing population is, of course, that agriculture has to expand somewhere else. And that would be in areas where it will actually have an enormous impact on biodiversity and ecosystems. So this is something we need to include in our understanding of how urbanization is related to biodiversity and ecosystems, and try to see how we could manage urbanization in a more sustainable way.
Eco-cities should enable their residents to live a good quality of life while using minimal natural resources. So part of the model includes, as much as possible, using local materials and utilizing local sun, wind, and rainfall as it flows through the system to their best advantage. The eco-city model also seeks to incorporate natural ecosystems into urban areas in order to both provide for local wildlife habitat, but also to enhance the experiences of urban public spaces. The compact, pedestrian-oriented eco-city model that's land and energy conserving, it makes a lot of room for not only agriculture, but for wild nature and open spaces, which means that it allows for a massive natural carbon sequestration. So that's in grasslands, in forests and wetlands. And this is critically important in this time, that we leave room for fixing some of the problems that we've created through our CO2 emissions over the years, that we've been building the wrong model of cities.